Henshaws, Apple accessibility, supporting people with sight loss and a range of other disabilities to go beyond expectations.
Welcome to Henshaws Tips, Tricks and Tech. Today I'm in a ball pool. We were thinking about where to film today and I thought, why don't we film in a ball pool? And Deb said, let's do it. So we're in the ball pool at Averton House in Old Trafford. And today I'm going to bring you a video on Apple. It's the first video, believe it or not, on Apple. This one's just going to be an overview of their accessibility features of Apple. Just a little bit about their accessibility features. There's lots. So it's not just for people with sight loss, it's people with hearing loss, and it's people with motor skill issues, i.e. have difficulty kind of holding, touching, doing the swipes and the gestures. So it's ability for anybody really with any disability, or a lot of disabilities, to be able to access the products. And that's not just, I've got a few around me, by the way. I've got my iPad here, these are mine, and I've got my MacBook Pro, and I've got my iPhone there, and I've got a Mac at home. It's all pretty much the same. So the accessibility features of Apple are pretty much the same on all devices. So when I go through the accessibility features of this iPad, they'll be similar to everything else, including the iPhone. So should we get into it? So where do you find this holy grail? Right, so the first place you need to go are settings. Okay, so on mine I've got settings right in the middle because I go to it quite often. So I'm just going to click on settings. And then you want to go to general. So there's general just there on the left hand side. And right in the middle of the page, there's something called accessibility. So I'm just going to click on that. Right, there's a bunch of stuff here. So there's stuff on vision. There's stuff on interaction. There's stuff on hearing. There's elements called media and learning. Okay, so vision. In the vision section, there's something called voiceover, zoom, magnifier, display accommodations, and speech. What we're going to do in other videos, we're going to literally go down each one. So we're really going to section these videos in very small elements so you can kind of get to them. Later on down there, there's things called larger text and bold text, increasing contrast. Honestly, you can really adapt the experience of a user, no matter if they've got some vision or no vision. It really doesn't matter. You can access Apple products with absolutely no vision by going through some of these actual features. But I'm just going to touch on VoiceOver and Zoom, just so you can kind of get your head around that. VoiceOver, that's really for somebody with really low sight, pretty much no sight to be fair. So you access that by using gestures and by listening, okay? So no sight needed at all. Zoom is for people with low vision. So zoom is really magnification. So it's going to magnify some of the elements on the screen and enable somebody to see with what sight they've got left. The other things are pretty cute as well, magnifier and speech, I love them. But we'd, like I say, this is a video about just getting your head around the features of it. So listen, we're pretty much done on this video. I'm gonna finish off by saying, check out the other videos on Apple on our playlist. We're gonna try and get three done today, hopefully. So that'll be good. But honestly, there'll be about 15 Apple, just on Apple. We've got lots of other videos on hacks, on daily living, on products, on applications. So check all our other videos out and subscribe and comment and like. And if you want to be in video and you're kind of in Greater Manchester area, come in my ball pool. Yeah? Right, so I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.